ends and it pours when you're out on your own. If I crash on the couch, can I sleep in my clothes? If it looks like I'm laughing, I'm really just asking to leave this alone. You're in time for the show. You're the one that I need. I'm the one that you loathe. You can watch me corrode like a beast in repose. Cause I love all the poison away with the boys in the band.
WCVH proudly presents The Morning Show.
Good afternoon. Today is Tuesday, November 6th.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "Hate comes from intimidation. Love comes from appreciation," by Tyga. Lunch for today is roasted turkey and no hot combo. And lunch for tomorrow is pepperoni pinwheel and Subway Day. Now, over to your weather report.
Okay. Yep, ready? Hey, what's up, you guys? Today is going to be thunderstorming all day,
with a high of 65 and a low of 45.
Now over to headline news.
That was really good quality content.
A very specific threat from a North Korean official has analysts worried. The threat came with a clear call for the U.S. to ease its sanctions against North Korea. If not, the country may resume building up nuclear forces, said a North Korean foreign ministry official on state television.
It does reflect their position. It also reflects the stance that they have, that they don't want to give up much.
This warning comes days before. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has scheduled a sit-down with his North Korean counterpart in New York.
North Korea always, before a meeting, tries to gain leverage by perhaps issuing threatening language or insinuating a threat. You know, that said, we don't want to just dismiss it as negotiating rhetoric.
Analysts say North Korea could once again work on long-range missiles that may be able to reach the U.S.
If they do test, everything will come to a halt. And we're really back to where we were a year ago.
That's back to when there were talks about a possible U.S. missile strike against North Korea. If Pyongyang didn't tone down its behavior, another factor in this potential situation, Tuesday's midterm elections. Experts say North Korea is paying close attention.
They want to see how much the incumbent in the White House, does he have support? I think they're looking for whether President Trump gets weakened or not.
I'm Sophia Steed, reporting.
Attention seniors, now it's time to order your cap and gown and graduation stationery products. The deadline for these orders is Wednesday, November 21st. Please be sure to return your order to Mr. Berbiger in room 100. Or even easier, place your order online at www.sscgradstore.com by this date. Oakleaf Manor is hiring. You must be at least 16 years old. They have locations in both Landisville and Millersville. To learn more or to apply, please visit livecardinal.com. Attention Powder Puff players, coaches, and cheerleaders. All money and waivers due to Mr. Shank in room 103 by Thursday, November 8th. Please be sure to submit all money in person. Now over to Word of the Day.
Your Word of the Day today is tremulous. It is an adjective meaning characterized by quivering or unsteadiness.
Anna, I come bearing gifts.
Boy.
Who's coming for?
Here's your letter.
Awesome.
No way! Stanford University, my dream school!
Why are your hands so tremulous?
I don't know, open this, I'm too nervous.
Right.
You suck. No.
And that was your word of the day.
Attention all staff and students. It will be returning after Thanksgiving. What joyous news indeed. Stay tuned for more. There will be open bowling on Tuesday for any and all interested students in joining the bowling program. The new coach, Mr. Doug Davidson, will be there to answer any and all questions. The cost is $3 per bowler. The first true practice will be November 19th and 20th at Dutch Lanes from 3:30 to 5:30. The CTC's open house is on November 8th from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. at all three locations. This is a great opportunity for you and your parents to visit the different programs that the CTC has to offer. If you have any questions about the open house, please stop in the guidance office. Now over to CV Sports.
Anyone interested in winter track should report to an after-school meeting on November 12th immediately after school in the cafeteria. Important information about the season will be discussed regarding the upcoming season.
Come out and support the Bucks.
Now for sports highlights.
Clips. Now you're settling for field goals.
Maher, 38-yard attempt, and that's what they're going to do here on second and goal. He looks back to Cooper. Can he get in? Diving for it. His first touchdown with the star on the helmet.
On that two-point conversion there, they threw a pass. It'd be interesting to see if they try to get on the perimeter or run the football.
Derrick Henry at 247 pounds is in for the touchdown.
Advantage of it when it presents itself.
38 yards on third and 10. And now back to Lewis, and Lewis has blockers in front, and into the end zone, Deion Lewis.
Turn, and then come back underneath.
Second and 10, as Cooper just looks on. Wide open, touchdown, Allen Hurns. The back with Mariota. As he pulls, and it goes underneath the Smith. Beautiful play by the Titans for the score. So instead, it's Ryan Succop. Off the upright.
One.
Here it is, third and one. Mariota. He's just going to go ahead and go right in himself.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Sydney.
Alongside Brody.
And this is CV Today.
At a Teletubby TV Show. Llévame, 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 llévame.